mother was born in poverty. My grandmother was 15 years old and unwell. And once she was pregnant, the family didn't want her there. And so that means now she's jobless. Just tell us just a little bit about what happened to her when she was 6 months old. So her mother's 15, so she's probably 15 and a half at that point. And my mother got pneumonia. And she tried everything she could. She took her, now Aiken is still rural to me because I grew up in the big city of Los Angeles. But it was even more rural in 1925. And so the doctor, the town doctor said, well, there's nothing we can do for her. And so she did what a lot of us do. We go to the big sister. And she took my mother to Colesville, Pennsylvania, which her older sister, Mary, says, I'll take care of her. Well, obviously my mother lived till she was 87 years old, so she did a good job of taking care of her. And it says it's about a year later, Carrie came back to take my mother back in possession, and her sister told her, no, Essie's my baby now. You go and have a good life. And she was obedient to that, and she did leave her there. Okay, so now you're trying to compute this. Okay, that my aunt. Okay, that's my aunt now. That's not my mother. And I have another father. So she did return in about 6 months. And she took her to an office in Edgefield. He was an attorney and working in the government at the time. And so a nice black gentleman answered the door. And she said, I was thinking, oh my God, this is my father. We meet my father for the first time. But he says, come in, and I will see if I believe governor at the time will see you, have a seat. And so they waited, and then he showed them in, and they walked in, closed the door, and she says, Essie Mae, this is your father. A little shock therapy once again. Never even thought of herself as having white in her. Is that from that moment forward, Strom Thurmond stayed in touch with her. So when she's graduating high school, he said, well, what are you going to do now? You're going to college, right? And she said, well, yes, I want to go to nursing school. And he says, well, great. So she went to nursing school in New York. Well, she finished nursing school, and she wanted to work at the New York hospital. And she was told, well, you can't work here. And she said, but I've done all my training here. I love this hospital. She says, no, you have to go to Harlem. You have to go over where they hired the colored nurses. And my mother was so frustrated. So imagine at this point, she's about 20 in that picture. So she's learned things through her 20 years of life. And everything is constantly pointing separatism, separatism, separatism.